signore! Vi respingiamo, signore! Preparatevi! Sì, signore! Ripiegate! Certo, signore. Sì, signore. Preparatevi. Sì, signore!
Questo è il fiore. Questo è il fiore del
Paese. Avanzate!
Questo è il fiore.
Avanzate!
Questo è il fiore del partigiano.
Avanzate!
Questo è il fiore. Questo è il fiore del partigiano. Questo è il fiore.
Continuate
questo
ad avanzare!
Il fiore del partigiano.
Ripiegate!
Mi sono alzato. Bella ciao, bella ciao, bella ciao, 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 una mattina. Mi sono alzato. E ho trovato l'invasor. Oh partigiano, portami via. Oh bella ciao, bella ciao, bella ciao, ciao, ciao. Partigiano, portami via. Che mi sento.
Pronto, signore! Continuate ad avanzare!
Partigiano,
preparatevi!
Minister has come back from his third and greatest journey, and he says
that the settlement of the Czechoslovakian problem, which has now been achieved, is, in my view, only the prelude to a larger settlement in which all Europe may find peace. This morning, I had another talk with the German Chancellor, Herr Hitler. Here is the paper which bears his name upon it as well as mine. Some of you perhaps have already heard what it contains, but I would just like to read it to you. We, the German Führer and Chancellor, and the British Prime Minister have had a further meeting today and are agreed in recognizing that the question of Anglo-German relations is of the first importance for the two countries and for Europe. We regard the agreement signed last night and the Anglo-German naval agreement as symbolic of the desire of our two peoples never to go to war with one another again. We are resolved that the method of consultation shall be the method adopted to deal with any other questions that may concern our two countries. We are determined to continue our efforts to remove possible sources of difference and thus to contribute to assure the peace of Europe.
Formazione. Sì, signore. Avanzate. Formazione. Pronto. Avanzate. Thank you.
speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, that a state of war would exist in us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently, this country is at war with Germany. You can imagine what a bitter blow it is to me that all my long struggle to win peace has failed. Yet I cannot believe that there is anything more or anything different that I could have done and that would have been more successful. Up to the very last, it would have been quite possible to have arranged a peaceful and honest.
Mr. Speaker, on Friday evening last, I received His Majesty's...
Formazione! 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 Pronto! Muovetevi! Continuate ad avanzare! Ritirata!
Can you conceive the greater objective to the Germans in the air than to make evacuation from these beaches impossible and to sink all these ships which were destroyed almost to the extent of thousands? Could there have been an objective
of
military importance and significance for the whole
Ripiegate!
They tried hard. They were frustrated in their task. We got the army away. They have paid fourfold for any losses which they have inflicted. Sir, when we consider how much greater would be our advantage in pay my tribute to these young airmen. The great French army was very largely, for the time being, cast back and disturbed by the onrush of a few thousands of armored vehicles. May it not also be that the force of civilization itself will be defended by the and devotion of a few thousand.
Preparatevi!
There never had been, I suppose, in all,
sì, signore.
In all the history of war, such an opportunity for you.
Avanzate!
The Knights of the Round Table, the Crusaders, all fall back into the past. Not only distant, but prosaic. These young men going forth every morn to guard their native land and all that we stand for, holding in their hands these instruments,
sì, signore,
of colossal and shattering power, of whom it may be said that every morn brought,
sì, signore,
forth a noble chance, and every chance brought forth a noble knight.
Pronto, signore!
Deserve our gratitude, yes, to all.
Avanzate!
In so many ways and on so many occasions, are ready. And continue ready.
Avanzate!
Life and all. Nevertheless, our thankfulness at the escape of our army and so many men whose loved ones have passed through
formazione,
agonizing weeks, does not blind us to the fact that what happens in France and Belgium is a colossal military disaster. The French army has been weakened. The Belgian army has been lost. A large part of those fortified lines for which so much faith had been reposed is gone. Many valuable mining districts and factories
formazione
in the enemy's possession. All of the channel ports are in his hands, with all the tragic consequences that follow from that. And we must expect another blow to be struck almost immediately at us or at France. We are told, sir, that Herr Hitler has a plan for invading the British Isles. This has often been thought of before. When Napoleon lay at Boulogne for a year with his flat-bottomed boats and his grand army, he was told by someone, there are bitter weeds in England. There are certainly a great many more of them since the British expeditionary force returned. Sir, I have myself full confidence that if all do their duty, if nothing is neglected, and if the best arrangements are made, as they are being made, we shall prove ourselves once more able to defend our island home, to ride out the storm of war, and to outlive the menace of tyranny, if necessary for years, if necessary alone. At any rate, that is what we are going to try to do. That is the resolve of His Majesty's government, every man of them. That is the will of Parliament and the nation. The British Empire and the French Republic, linked together in their cause and in their need, will defend to the death their native soil, aiding each other like good comrades to the utmost of their strength. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall flight, with growing confidence and growing strength in the air, we shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills.
Pronto, signore!
We'll never surrender.
Formazione!
And if I do
pronto,
not
signore.
For a moment believe this island or a large part of it were subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet, would carry on the struggle until in God's good time the new world with all its power and might steps forth to the rescue and the liberation of the old.
Avanzate! Pronto, signore! Pronto, signore! Pronto, signore! Signore! Avanzate! Pronto! Avanzate! Avanzate! Pronto! Avanzate! Pronto, signore! Formazione! Pronto, signore! Avanzate! signore! Avanzate! Pronto! Pronto, signore! Pronto, signore! Pronto! Sì, signore! signore! Avanzate! Vi respingiamo, signore!
Mr. Speaker, the disastrous military events which have happened during the past fortnight have not come to me with any sense of surprise. Indeed, I indicated a fortnight ago, as clearly as I could to the House, that the worst possibilities were open. And I made it perfectly clear that whatever happened in France would make no difference to the resolve of Britain and the British Empire to fight on. If necessary for years, if necessary.
Azione!